Industrial data exchange between field devices can be achieved with the Modbus communication protocol. Let's see how that can be done with the ESP32 and FLProg SCADA. We will walk through the steps for setting up Modbus communication between the ESP32 and FLProg SCADA. Expand the communication option in the project tree to reveal Modbus. The protocol involves the exchange of data between a master and several slave devices. We will be programming the ESP32 as a slave device. The Modbus RTU and the TCP are two variants of the Modbus protocol. The Modbus RTU or serial is transmitted over the RS-485 hardware protocol, while the TCP is over the Ethernet protocol. Let's work with the RTU today. Expand Modbus Slave 1 and double-click on Address. Modbus address can be assigned to multiple slave devices with unique addresses from 1 to 255. The master device usually assumes address 0. Note that the assigned slave address is what is indicated here. The hardware protocol is configured with the UART option. Double-click on UART and select the available UART ports on your board. The required communication speed can be selected here, but I will leave it at 9600. The PEDE option is determined by the type of TTL to RS-485 converter connected to the controller board. For this board type connection to the RX and TX pins of the ESP32, double-click on PEDE to select the DE-ROE pin connection. This other board type requires the selection of No, which is also used for a point-to-point connection with a computer. Modbus data types under variables are grouped as coils to read from and write to digital outputs and variables. To read digital inputs and variables, discrete inputs are required. Input registers are used to read from analog inputs and variables, while holding registers read from and write to analog variables. To demonstrate Modbus communication, set up this circuit with the ESP32. A push-button switch is connected to pin D12 as a Modbus digital input. An LED is connected to pin D14 as a Modbus digital output. A potentiometer is connected to pin D35 as a Modbus analog input. And an LCD to display Modbus analog output. The RX pin of the TTL to RX-485 converter is connected to the TX pin of the ESP32. And the TX pin of the converter connects to the RX pin of the ESP32. A USB to RX-485 converter like this one is required to connect a Modbus network to the computer. The pin A of the USB to RX-485 converter will connect to that of the TTL to RX-485 converter. So also are their pins B. Multiple TTL to RX-485 converters can be connected like this for additional slave devices over distances of up to 1 kilometer. Now, let's create a program to demonstrate the Modbus functions. Add a digital input to pin D12 with the name switch and enable bands protection and pull-up resistor. Add an analog input to pin D35 with the name ports. Add a digital output to pin D14 with the name LED. Drag a timer block into the program. Configure it as a symmetric multivibrator with a pulse length of 1000 milliseconds. Drag the switch input and the LED output into the program and connect them to the timer block. Expand the coil at the left and double-click to add a coil tag with the name LED. The Modbus data addresses for the coil, discrete inputs, input register, and holding registers should be any number from 0 to 9999. Expand the discrete input and add a tag with the name switch. Drag the tags into the program and connect them respectively to the input and output of the timer. Then upload the code to the ESP32. Create a new SCADA project from the file menu and expand the tree. Expand the connection option and double-click to add a connection. Choose Modbus RTU Master. Expand RS232, the port settings, and double-click on Ports. Select the port that has the USB to RS485 converter connected. Ensure that the port speed corresponds to that of the ESP32. Expand the Modbus Master and add a Modbus slave with a corresponding address to that of the ESP32. Expand the Modbus slave and variables and add a Modbus coil and a discrete input the same as that of the ESP32 program. Then expand and add a screen. Expand the created screen 1 and double-click on Edit Screen. From the widgets library on the right, drag 2 RAND indicator controls into the program. Adjust to the required size and left-click. Drag in 2 text elements and place them below the indicator controls. Double-click on the first text and change the text to switch. Also, change the second text to LED. Now, double-click on the switch indicator and select the variable option. Click here to select a variable and navigate down the connection options to select the switch tag. Repeat the same steps to select the LED tag for the other indicator. Then click on the Check Project icon. Observe that when the switch is held down, the switch indicator on the SCADA turns green, while the LED of the circuit and the indicator on the SCADA flashes every second. A soft switch to start the flashing of the LED can also be created on the SCADA. Add another soft switch coil tag in FLProg and drag it into the program. Disconnect the switch from the timer input and place an OR block between them. Connect the switch and the soft switch coil tag to the input of the OR block and the output of the OR block to the input of the timer. Then upload the code to the ESP32. Create a similar soft switch tag in FLProg SCADA. Drag a simple button control into the program and set the required size. Double-click on it and change the text to soft switch. Also, select the soft switch tag from the variable option. Go to the Events tab and add the press event. Select the set values of variable action. Then navigate to select the soft switch tag from here and choose the true value. Now, click on the Check Project icon and hold down the left mouse button on the soft switch button. Observe that the LED indicator is flashing as required. Add a new board to the FLProg program. Drag the port analog input and a scale block into the board and connect them. Set the scale block upper limit of the input to 4095 and the upper limit of the output to 100. Then expand the Modbus input register option and add a port and a scale tag. Drag in and connect the Modbus port tag to the analog input and the Modbus scale tag to the output of the scale block. Then upload the code. In FLProg SCADA, add similar tags for port and scale input registers and drag them into the screen. Add plain text below them to identify them. Double-click on the first and remove the text in the editor. Set the width to 80 and the height to 30. Do the same for the other editor control. Then click on the Check Project icon. Observe that the potentiometer's raw value and the scale value are displayed on the SCADA screen. Finally, add another board and drag a timer and a counter into it. Invert the input of the timer and select the symmetrical multivibrator type with a pulse width of 500 milliseconds. Set the counter to the down counter type. Enable the preset input and when the lower limit is reached input. Then select stop counting down. Observe that additional inputs of SP, P and min were added to the counter. Connect the timer to the C input of the counter and a converter string block to its output. Drag in an LCD display and select the I2C connection type with an address of 27 in my case. Impute counter as the data constant. Set the row to 1 and check the to center. Invert the EN input of the display, then copy and paste it. Select the data input and row 2 of the second display. Then connect the converter string block to the data input of the display. Now, add 3 holding register tags of preset, limit, counter, and a coil of set counter. Drag the tags to the program and connect the set counter to the counter SP input, preset to P, and limit to the min input of the counter. Connect the counter tag to the V output of the counter, then upload the code to the ESP32. Create similar holding register tags in FLProg SCADA. Drag in a simple button with the text and variable of set counter. Also, configure the press event with the set counter tag. Drag in the 3 holding registers. Set their width and height to 80 and 30 respectively. And label them with plain text accordingly. Finally, click on the Check Project icon. Double-click on the preset text and impute a preset value for the counter. Also, impute a lower limit value for the counter. Then press the left mouse on the Set Counter button. Observe that the counter value as displayed on the SCADA and on the LCD starts decreasing from the preset value and stop at the limit value. I am sure this video must have been helpful or at least interesting to you. If so, please like the video and subscribe to this channel if you have not already done so. Also, drop your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope to see you soon.